So, hi, if you are a parent of a child or an adult child with epilepsy, specifically autism and epilepsy, this is for you. Are you as fed up as I am with the whole con job of, well, basically autism and epilepsy research because it's a continual con game? Every piece of research you read always, do you ever notice it always ends with more research needed? How much research do you need? Okay, at some point, somebody should be monitoring these people like, hey, Harold, you've been over there in the corner for 30 years playing with those mice. It's about time you show us some progress or get the hell out and we're going to replace you. But that's a whole other video. Right now, I'm really angry about the fact that there is very little progress with epilepsy. And epilepsy is a nightmare. It is terrible to watch your child have a seizure. And it is e equally frustrating and mind-blowing to constantly hear limited and vague and ambiguous information from alleged professionals. I don't want to blame neurologists or epileptologists too much because they're limited, right, on what is available to them. And well, let's check it out here. According to research, the current available anti-epileptic drugs have a limited efficacy. That means, let's hear that again. Currently available anti-epileptic drugs have a limited efficacy, and their negative properties limit their use and cause difficulties in patient management, specifically causing adverse effects that are detrimental to a patient. Well, isn't that swell? Great. Thank you, Harold, and all of you other researchers who have been sitting in the corner for 50 years and or less or more. And what have you shown us other than more research is needed? At what point are we going to get above this? If I'm still reading, and this is a July 10 all the way to 2022 stuff that I'm looking at here, where people are continuing to document the failure of epileptic treatments and advances. So sorry, I don't know, I lost my voice of some rhinovirus. So anyway, it is pathetic and disgusting and frustrating on so many levels. I've freaking had it. I really have. I don't see any accountability here. Like, what other profession can you be in where you just sit in, you sit in these universities for years, doling out research, just writing another paper, regurgitating the same thing that you researched 5, 10 years ago with a new spin, and then you end it again with more research needed to keep that grant money coming. You see how it goes? It's a con job. That's what I'm thinking. I don't care if you disagree with me. I think it is. As a mother, I've watched this for years. It's a freaking con job. I mean, who else gets to do this? Somebody. There should be a time limit as a researcher, right? When you're doing this, when you're researching autism and epilepsy, things of such significance and I mean, there's an exigent and imminent threat here to these people. They need help. And you're sitting in a corner for 50 years just casually researching this? Like, what the hell? No, you need to go. Go to take your degree, go somewhere else, get a new profession. You know, we don't need you. You're not helping us. So I'm just at a loss here as to how this continues, and there's no accountability in these places. Who we have to do better. Like, I don't, maybe we never will. You know, maybe we're just at a point. Excuse me, my cat is clawing the door. Yeah, come on in, Minnie. Sure, thank you. You know, we're at a point now where it's just beyond absurd. We have to do better. We have to do better. This is so stupid. I'm so tired of the low-level intellect surrounded, not that I'm some brilliant person, but the low-level intellect. I don't have a medical degree, right? Like, you expect more from people. You ha show, you hold them to a higher standard when they have PhDs and MDs, correct? Right. I mean, I don't have one. I have a master's degree. So, I'm not saying I'm better than anyone or I'm more intelligent. I'm just saying I'm a little concerned that every time you read this research, it is really low-level stuff. You ever heard of Bloom's taxonomy? There's like this triangle, and the lowest level of critical thinking is knowledge, just like knowing something. Like, you'll have these experts or professionals tell, well, I know, have you the neurons and this and that. Okay, well, thanks, you know it. Well, that's great. Well, Do you understand it? Can you analyze it? Can you apply it? Can you come up with a solution? Is there any problem solving going on here? Okay, that's super duper that you know it, but that's not going to solve things just because you know something, okay? Anyone can memorize it. You know, a homeless person on Adderall can memorize something. I want to know if you can actually solve something here. Ah, my God. It's just like, really? I'm so frustrated right now. I'm just so done with the trying Keppra, trying Lamictal, and that's not working. Then, oh, we'll just increase the Versed. No, there's a maximum dose on Versed. What do you want us to just benzo out our autistic kid all day? Like, you know, I mean, he's not a kid. He's 33 years old, but he's, you know, obviously is in the mind of a 2-year-old. And, you know, I still call him a kid because he is a kid in his mind. He still sucks his thumb. Oh, God, it's just so frustrating.